What do you think, by the way, Ryan Garcia, Luke Campbell, so it's Ryan's toughest fight. Luke Campbell, former gold medalist, a southpaw. Ryan, 20-0, 17 knockouts.
To be honest, I don't know much about Campbell.
He fought Loma.
He fought Loma. I think that's the only time I've seen him, but, you know, he's a fighter from the UK. So, it's honestly hard to follow those guys because they fight on different time frames.
Devin Haney, there's a lot of talk of him fighting Gary Russell or Gamboa. But what do you think about that one?
Bro, I'm not a fan of the fight.
Why?
Because I'm not a fan of the fight because I don't try to shit on fighters or disrespect fighters. I'm just personally don't like Gary Russell's fighting style.
And I mean, he's very talented.
I mean,
he's a champion.
Yeah, but I mean, look, you know, certain guys don't like my style. And I mean, I'm just, you know, not a fan of his style.
So it sounds like you're saying
to me, his style is very amateurish. It's and it's very like, you know, that type of style where it's cool. Some people like it. I'm not trying to knock them, but it's just not a.
So him and Crawford, if it happened.
Who?
He and Crawford were going back and forth.
And Gary.
Yeah, you saw that, right?
Crawford's on a whole nother level, man.
Crawford and Kell Brook.
I'm just saying, there's just certain guys that. You know what I mean? Just because the guy's a boxer doesn't mean you have to like his style. Like, I respect him as a fighter. You know what I mean? I see him, I respect him, man. You know what I mean? Because, you know, we gladiators. What we do is gladiator shit.
You have to respect every fighter.
I mean, I don't got to like his style.
Okay. Gap, according to Gabe Rosado, top five fighters right now active, top five fighters in history.
Top five fighters right now active. I'm not going to say this in order, but the top five fighters now, I'm going to go with Crawford. I'm gonna go with Spence. I'm gonna go with Canelo. I'm gonna go with Fury.
One more.
And one more. One more. I'm gonna go with the dude that just moved up the heavyweight.
Usyk.
Oh, Usyk.
Okay, and top five in history?
Top five in history. I'm gonna go with Muhammad Ali. I'm gonna go with Floyd Mayweather. I'm gonna go with Muhammad Ali, Floyd Mayweather, Roberto Duran. Roberto Duran. Damn, you got me stuck. Muhammad Ali, Floyd Mayweather, Roberto Duran. I will go with Chavez. And I gotta go with a Puerto Rican fighter, right? So it's between Benitez, Wilfredo Gomez, or Tito Trinidad.
Trinidad.
Yeah, we're gonna mix it up.
Whoever. You agree with your brother's list?
I agree.
How about the active fighters? You have the same vibe?
Active fighters, I mean, I'll go whatever he says. I'm rocking out with that.
Yeah. With the active fighters, man, you definitely gotta go with that list.
There's a lot of Inouye's really good. Mm-hmm.
But yeah, with the of all time top five, I go with Muhammad Ali because for a man that weighed 215 and being that elusive and that slick, even in this era with bigger men, he would still dominate.
That's true.
You know what I mean? And then Roberto Duran, that
135 to 68. Roberto Duran,
yeah. That his the angles and everything, the slip, the punching power, crazy. I mean, like when he did that Barkley. At
168, yep.
That's crazy. You know what I mean? And then and then you got to go with Floyd Mayweather.
50-0.
Because they don't give him his props, but you got to go with Floyd. I mean, the man, when he was Pretty Boy Floyd, he was killing everybody.
It's true.
And he became Money May, and he obviously became a little more defensive.
And he still beat everybody.
He still beat everybody.
And he made a billion, which doesn't hurt.
And Chavez, you know, 100 fights.
89-0,
The man, the way he went to the body. That's probably one of the best body punches in the game when it comes to Chavez. And then, you know, Wilfredo Gomez. Man, Wilfredo Gomez went 35-0, like 35 knockouts. The man was crazy slippery. Benitez probably has top five best defense of all time. And then Tito Trinidad at 47 was knocking everybody's head off.
Okay, him and Oscar in a rematch.
Trinidad. Look, and Trinidad beat Oscar the first time. A lot of people say... they robbed Oscar. If you look at that fight and put that shit on mute and don't listen to the biased-ass, dumb-ass commentators from HBO back in the day, I mean, who didn't know what the, like when Floyd told Larry Merchant, you don't know shit about boxing.
He didn't say
real shit. Everybody got mad at Floyd, but it's facts. Because if you look at those fights from back in the day and you heard the commentating from Larry Merchant on Floyd, it was dope. It was bullshit.
They're hating. They never
gave Floyd props. They always made I mean, it was never enough. It was bullshit. So when Floyd said that, I felt him. He's like, man, you don't know shit about boxing.
Then Larry Merchant said, if I was 80 years younger, I'd kick your ass or something.
Yeah, whatever, man. Whatever.
You still wouldn't kick his ass. But you know what? I think you could be a great announcer. So let's see if that happens one day.
For sure. But yeah, it's like.
But I agree. But listen, announcers work for networks. There's bias.
I want to say something. I want to finish my point real quick with the Tito and Oscar fight.
Yeah.
Tito won that fight because you just put the shit on mute. And don't listen to the fucking biased commentating. When Oscar was throwing combinations, only one punch would land. He was missing four punches and he'll land like one shot. And Tito was slipping, and he would throw the combos and it looked good, but then only one would land. But then when Tito landed one punch, it was big. It was solid blows. Tito was applying the pressure. The rounds were close. In the beginning, the championship rounds, Trinidad sealed the deal. All Oscar did was move. And the reason Oscar moved, he wants to blame it on his corner. But the thing is, Tito was putting them hands on him. And Tito was putting them hands on him. And Oscar knew, if I sit down with this man, he might get me out of there. So Oscar got on that bicycle. I gave him a boxing lesson. Shut your bitch ass up, Oscar. Shut your bitch ass up, Oscar. You got beat.
Hey, he's a 92 medalist, 10-time champion, six divisions. He was a great boxer. And let's see if he comes back. And let's see who he fights. It'll be interesting. You know, The Zone said, and this is according to what I've read, The Zone said Oscar Canelo would sell like crazy. Oscar Canelo and Masvidal would sell.
I'll pay $200 pay-per-view for that shit. I'll buy ringside tickets.
For Oscar Canelo?
I see Canelo. Fuck Oscar.
You agree? You think Canelo wins?
Right. Yo. Because look, man, here's the thing. Oscar, as far as a fighter, he accomplished a lot of things. The man was a great fighter.
10-time champ, six
divisions. The man was a great fighter. I'm not going to front. Oscar was one of the best that ever did it.
Gold medalist.
Great jab. Yep. He had a great hook, great body punching. Oscar really was a great fighter. But on the promoter side, I mean, you know, he's not the best at it. You know what I'm saying? He's not the best at it. But love him as a fighter, as a promoter, not the best.
Did you fight for him?
Hell yeah. I fought for Golden Boy, man. Damn.
Do you ever talk to him when you fight for him? Do you have a connection to him or not so much?
Nah. I mean, let me tell you something. Oscar was on a good one time and he was like, what fight do you want? I said, give me Munguia. He said, I'm going to make that fight happen. And Mario Lopez was there. He told Mario Lopez, you just witnessed this. You're his witness. All right, I'm gonna make the Munguia fight. Never happened. Oscar up. He left that shit on red. I was like, oh damn, left that shit on red. I'd have fucked the Munguia up. You know what I'm saying? But my thing is this, you know, it would have been a great fight.
It would have been a great fight. I would have loved to see it. Now Oscar's always been good to me. No, he's always treated me with respect. So I don't have those experiences. So,
I don't got nothing against Oscar. I'm just saying, you know what I mean? Look,
you would have loved that fight.
Look, yeah. Shit speaks for itself. Problems with Canelo, problems with Ryan, problems with other fighters. You know what I mean? Like, you know, I didn't have the best time on that side as well. You know what I mean? So it is what it is.
All right, there you have it. Everybody follow King Gab Rosado on Instagram and Twitter and the gym.
Ready, go bad.
Ready, go bad. BAD. Stay tuned. FeasersReporting.com. Elie Seckbach reporting. Are you on social media?
Oh, no, I'm all right. I'm good.
All right. What says on the shirt? Ali?
Nah, man.
Ali's autograph back in the day looked very similar to that. Right. Stay tuned. FeasersReporting.com. Elie Seckbach reporting.
Wow. What kind of last fight was November?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's crazy.
Knockout, Kovalev.
Yup.
He won. How about this? Nick Diaz looks in phenomenal shape. I know you sparred Nate Diaz right here in this gym. What do you think about the Diaz brothers? Looking phenomenal, ready to come back and do big things. Maybe it's Nate against Masvidal rematch, and Nick against anybody.
No, for sure, man. I like the Diaz brothers. I mean, you know, Nate came over here to the gym. You know, we boxed. I mean, he hit me up. You know, I was like, yo, I'm at Freddy's gym. Pulled up. Let's work. You know what I mean? So it didn't work out because I think I ended up going to the time he was gonna show up. I think I ended up going to Joshua Tree or something like that for the week. But
out there. What did you lose over there?
No, we just went out.
Joshua Tree has a I need a visa if I go there. That is far. That's really far.
A little getaway with the crew.
Why not? You have to sometimes clear your mind.
You know what I'm saying, hit the trails up over there. So, but yeah, Nate's dope, man. I'm gonna hit him up actually because we're in the works of finalizing something. So with the Zone and Eddie. So it'd be great work.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach.